गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास. टुडे इज़ माई टॉपिक ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन इज ट्राइजेमल न्यूरेल्जिया. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इज अबाउट वॉट इज ट्राइजेमल न्यूरेल्जिया. इट इज़ एक्चुअली अ न्यूरोपैथिक डिसऑर्डर ऑफ यू नो ऑफ ट्राइजेमल पेन. लाइक यू नो दैट दिस इज द ट्राइजेमल नर्व एंड देयर इट इज कैरेक्टराइज बाय द एपिसोड ऑफ इंटेंस पेन इन साइड द फेस विच ओरिजिनेट्स फ्रॉम द trigeminal nerve. Here you see there is a trigeminal nerve, all right, which first of all which will occur on the head, there below the eyes and in the mandible side or the face. So this is known as trigeminal neuralgia. In the etiology, actually it can be caused by the demyelination or the stress or compression or immunological factors, tumor or multiple sclerosis, trauma or genetic tendency. These are all the causes or etiology. What are the pathophysiology? Compression of blood vessels, especially the superior cerebral artery, occurs in which there will be a compression over the blood vessels, due to which the superior cerebral artery, in the cerebral artery it occurs, and there will be a chronic irritation of the trigeminal nerve at the root entry zone. Alright, where the root entry zone of the trigeminal nerves is there, the chronic irritation occurs, which will increase firing of the afferent and sensory fibers, which will lead to the trigeminal neuralgia, because it is a very painful disease. And Salman Khan is also affected by that, and he is having his treatment. His left eye is actually, if you see, his left eye is little bit drooping. So he had done the plastic surgery, and you know, he is being treated in New York in this center. All right. Second one is, next is like in trigeminal neuralgia, what will happen? The clinical features, like excruciating pain or burning pain or knife like someone is pinpointing, or the lightning shock in the lips, upper of the lower gums, cheeks, forehead or the side of the nose. There will be a heavy pain, intense pain, or there will be a twitching, grimacing and frequent blinking and tearing of the eye. Means if you see a patient with the trigeminal neuralgia, there will be an intense pain or twitching and grimacing and frequent blinking of the eye. The patient will blink the eye frequently, and tearing of the eye will be there, means the tears will flow from the eyes frequently. There will be a facial sensory loss. If you touch the face of the patient, then ask the patient, definitely he is going to say that he is not having that much of feel on his face, or there is no any kind of sensation over the face. Alright, next one, the diagnostic evaluation. So how actually we are going to diagnose the trigeminal neuralgia? In the trigeminal neuralgia, the diagnosis will be like history and physical examination. You have to check, then CT scan we have to do, audiologic evaluation we have to do. The audiologic evaluation is actually a series of diagnostic procedures which actually used to determine the type or the degree of hearing loss. You know, the goal of this evaluation is, you know, is to develop a treatment plan that is unique to the patient need in order to improve their communication skills. Then MRI we have to do, actually to rule out the multiple sclerosis, or electromyography. Electromyography is actually the recording of electric activity of the muscle tissue, alright. And then we have to examine for the CSF analysis. In CSF analysis, we are going to assess the cerebrospinal fluid, and arteriography we have to do. Actually, arteriography is nothing but an imaging test that use the X-ray or a special dye to see inside the arteries. That is arteriography. It can be used to view the heart, it can be used to view the brain, kidney or other part of the body. Then myelography, actually it is an imaging examination that in Actually, you know, the myelography, it is also an imaging examination that involves the introduction of this introduction of the spinal needle into the spinal canal and the injection of the contrast of the material in the space around the spinal cord and you know into the subarachnoid space using a real-time form of X-ray called fluoroscopy. Alright, next comes the pharmacological management. So in the pharmacological management, what we are going to give, we are going to give the carbamazepine or the tegretral, all right, and we have to go for phenytoin or dilantin, baclofen, amitriptyline, and diazepam. Alcohol or phenol may be injected into the affected branch of the trigeminal nerve or injection into the Jesserian ganglion. Surgical management is Janetta procedure. Actually, what do you mean by Janetta procedure? I will tell you. Janetta procedure is nothing but actually a microvascular decompression that is known as Janetta procedure. It is a neurological procedure used to treat the trigeminal neuralgia along with other cranial nerves neuralgias, a pain syndrome characterized by the severe episode of intense facial pain or any kind of spasm. Alright, so in this what we are going to do, actually there is an opening done inside the brain so that to check electric monitoring and the facial function of the hearing used, you know. So a straight incision is made with the surgical blade behind the ear, and just we have to expose the underlying brain covering, the dura mater, and then the cerebrum is allowed to fall out the way, exposing side to the brainstem, due to which actually we decompress the facial nerve, and then the wound is being flushed or cleaned with the saline solution, and the dura is closed after the procedure. So the patient is allowed to wake up after the procedure and is taken to an ICU for the close observation unit. Because we have to do the craniotomy as well to opening of the brain, so we have to reconstruct the overlying tissue and close the multiple layers that we have opened for the trigeminal neuralgia. Then comes this one, balloon compression. Balloon compression is meant by, as you've seen, that if there will be there is a compression inside the nerve, then we have to insert the balloon and then we have to inflate the balloon inside the nerve so that it should not be compressed. Alright, so we have to inflate the balloon inside that so that its function will be normal. Then glycerol injection and radio frequency rhizotomies we have to give into the trigeminal nerve. Then gamma knife radio surgery we can do for the patient. Alright, this is after the post surgery of the patient when you're going to perform the surgery or to assist the surgery. Then in foreign conditions you have to maintain the patient care because the cerebrum or cerebellum and the midbrain and the hindbrain is involved. Nursing management, instruct the patient to avoid exposing affected cheek to the sudden cold, avoid food that are too cold or too hot, chew food in affected site, administer tegretral which relieves or prevent pain, serum blood levels of drug are monitored in the long term use. Instruct the patient to in method to prevent the environmental stimulation of the pain, provide emotional support, provide adequate nutrition in small frequent meals at room temperature, use cotton pad gently, wash face and for oral hygiene, inspection of the eyes for foreign bodies which the client not able to feel should be done several times a day, warm normal saline irrigation of the affected eye 2 or 3 times a day is helpful for preventing corneal infection. Dental checkup we have to do because it will increase the rate of caries inside the tooth. So since the dental caries not produce pain, but still we have to check for that as well. Explain to the client and his family The disease in the nursing diagnose actually the chronic pain related to disease process, imbalanced nutrition, less than body requirements related to pain associated with the chewing, fear related to anticipated painful episodes, deficit knowledge of trigeminal neuralgia, complication, toxic side effect of the drugs may be occur, bone marrow or blood disorders, numbness of the face, eye, which may lead to the complications such as corneal abrasion. Surgical microvascular decompression may cause hemorrhage because we are opening the brain. There might be there will be a condition where hemorrhage can occur. Infection or brainstem damage will be the main complication. There will be residual face numbness, jaw weakness or corneal numbness following radio frequency, trigeminal ganglions, ganglionitis, etc. And hearing disturbances might be there. So, recurrent trigeminal neuralgia attributable to veins after the microvascular decompression. These are the methods which are the objective to, you know, demonstrate the cause of optimal treatment of the recurrent. Just take a look over this. I mean, this is a kind of study. Alright. Thank you. If you have any question, feel free to contact me. Thank you and have a nice day.